Up with it, girl. Rock with it, girl. Show them it, girl. With a bang bang. Bounce with it, girl. Dance with it, girl. Get with it, girl. With a bang bang.
Come on, come on. Turn the radio on. It's Friday night and I won't be long. Gotta do my hair, put my makeup.
To the floor and me see your energy because me not play no hide and seek. What is it the thing you ever make me feel weak, girl? Free! Cause anytime me whine and catch it, the selector pull it up and put it for repeat, girl. Me not touch a dollar in my pocket, cause nothing in this world ain't more than what you worth.
I don't need no money.
You worth more than diamond, more than gold.
As long as I can feel the beat,
make the beat just take control.
As long as I keep dancing.
Free up yourself, get out of control.
Baby,
okay guys, so it's late at night and I'm starting my pasteles, my beautiful lovely pasteles that I'm doing, and I'm doing a different twist this year. I'm actually doing sweet bananas and yuca. So I just cleaned them all out. So this is what I am doing. I'm doing a simple delicious pastel. So please, ladies, take notes, because these are little twists you can do in your kitchen. A pastel can be your own. Make it your own in your kitchen. So that's what I'm doing. I'm using sweet, and I'm doing, if you see behind me, these pots and pans are going crazy. About 2.5 hours, I had a whole penne in one, and then the other one, I have chicken. I have a whole chicken. So I'm doing chicken pasteles with sweet bananas and yuca. So I have my Bella blender here, as you see. Oh wait, not my Bella blender. That's my little one. This is my Cuisine Art. Love you, brother. Send me this way from California. So yeah, it's my Cuisine Art. It's usually where I do all my pasteles. So this girl's getting down for her crown up in the kitchen. What's up? And like I said, so I'm doing a different twist. If you watch my uploads, you will see the different challenges that I always do in my kitchen. And remember, it's your kitchen. So what you do, what you know, what works, know your flavors, know your ingredients, taste your stuff, be creative, and be awesome. And you can do it. All right. So, and the first ingredient is what I tell everybody, those of you that know, is cook with love. If you don't cook with love, nothing's gonna come out right. You can get all my ingredients that I am sharing in the description and step by step on the video. But if you don't cook with love, ladies, walk out the kitchen, take a breath, and come back. Okay, so that's how I get down to my kitchen. And I love to cook, as you guys know. So that's my twist, and I'm wrapping these up. I don't know, I'm gonna do as many as I can. So I'm doing some deliveries and just ups to everything that I got going on in my kitchen. So let's do a flip side so you can see the meat. All right, guys, so as you see, I have my hefty pan here and my other pan. My pernil is in here and my pollo is in here. Now, I actually had two whole chickens, but I'm only doing one today. And then I'm just gonna do as many as I can, as I mentioned. That is my pernil in there. And let me give you a peek-a-boo. And this is gonna be sitting for 2.5 hours. This is how I do my meat. And what I do is I let it sit overnight. And this is gonna come apart. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this, ladies. This is how you wanna do it. And from my island to yours with so much love, this is how my dad's side, Al Bonito, how they taught me, my dad taught me how to do my pernil. And how to make it so beautiful and tasty. So please take notes. And see, I'm putting a whole fork up in there. It still has a little ways to go, not much. But see, that's gonna fall off the bone, my dear. Trust me on that. All right, so 2.5 hours on a low. I don't like to do it too high. And then I kind of go back and forth, like blasting it, lowering it. You know, there's a mechanism to my madness, how I do this. But like I said, here we go. Now this is the chicken. Look at that. Say hi, chicken. Okay, so I guarantee you, I'm gonna put my fork in that too. And look, look, just look. Look how that's falling off the bone. So I did my first poke with you guys. Look, look, that's how you do it. I like to really clean my meat, as you guys know. So I wanted to share my first little poke with you guys and how I get down in my kitchen. And yes, this is going to sit for another, I say another 45 minutes. And this is done. I'm going to let it simmer down so beautifully. And the taste is outrageous. So please take those notes with all those little ingredients that I added into this. So this way you know what I'm using. Like I said, I don't put much in the description. I usually put deliciousness, 1, 2, 3, simple cooking, because it is 1, 2, 3, simple cooking. You just have to watch the video. That's the best way I do my description. All right, your girl, let's get to it.
up with it, girl. Rock with it, girl. Show them it, girl. With a bang bang. Bounce with it, girl. Dance with it, girl. Get with it, girl. With a bang bang.
Come on, come on. Turn the radio on. It's Friday night. And I won't be long. Gotta do my hair.
Okay, guys, so I am almost done with my masa. As you see, look at that. And if you could smell this with the sweet plantains, amazing. Super yummy. This is what I have left. This is where I'm going to be putting everything before I stick it onto my banana leaves and start my filling for my masa. And I have these pieces left and I am going to continue to rub on. And just for the record, I am using alkaline water for in between to mix to make it healthy. And that was my whole thing that I wanted to do today. Instead of making those pastelas that, you know, the masa can be a little fattening over the holidays, it's cool, but I prefer to do something different. Every holiday I do different twists, as you guys know. So therefore, yes, I'm definitely rocking out with a healthy pollo con yuca and sweet plantains. Okay, it's something very simple, clean. I'm doing everything super clean. As you guys know how I am so funny about my meat, that has to stay clean with my apple cider, lemon mix, and salt. Those of you that don't know, it's basically like something you can do at home. And I've done this since COVID, and it tenderizes your meat too. So take some notes. Anyway, with that being said or whatever, whatnot, this is fall off the bone. This is definitely ready to pop out. You see that? Really, really smoky the way I like it. Oh no. Yeah, these bad boys are ready to cool down, and then I'm gonna turn them off right now. It's about 11 midnight. Yes, this girl's rocking out. You guys know how I get down in my kitchen, those of you that know your girl. Okay, so all I gotta do is add some ingredients to the masa. I do a simple salsón, not too much, a little bit of parsley flakes, and a garlic powder. And that is just for my masa. There's many ways you can flavor your masa, but I put so much flavor into that chicken and into that deliciousness of pork. That's a pork, it's a pork butt. I was gonna do the pork shoulder, pork butt got more juiciness to it, so we went that way. So, all right guys, so I'll catch you in a little bit, and I will be wrapping these up with those beautiful leaves, which I got. I have to clean my table so I can get busy, your girl. Okay guys, so it is time for the magic. So I'm done doing all the masa, all the pork is done, everything is done. Check out my uploads, I can't express that enough. I did over like 30 pounds of masa all by myself, and not with this machine. This is why my brother actually sent me this machine, because I did it guayando with the guayando. So, yes, I did it with this, 30 pounds. So check out your girl. I got a strong arm. However, I am very grateful for my brother to have sent me this a couple years ago. And it does work, and it saves me a lot of time. So, looking down here, I sprinkled a little bit of the parsley. Now, I have the chef... sofrito here. It is con achote, and that is what I mix with the masa. I forgot to add that in there earlier in my earlier video. And of course the sesong, and I do everything very lightly because I want to keep it on a healthy note. So I have a lot going on here. As you look over here, I have my paper, my scissors, my string, and these are the banana leaves that I got, the frozen ones, the hojas, and then here they go. So I have a lot of work to do, this girl. So I wanted to wait till after the holidays to do this because, you know, I have my own people that I go to, and also you know, like I said, we just moved into this house and we got a lot going on, so therefore I didn't have the chance to do it for the holidays. But however, I'm doing it now, and I am going to up my deliveries. Super excited. All right guys, so let's go ahead and do it. Let me show you the breakdown of the simple, just mixing it. Okay guys, so here we go. Okay, and all these ingredients that I add in is gonna go into all this masa. So this masa, this masa, this masa, and this that's left over in my cuisine art. And I'm going to be using this pitcher to pour it onto my leaves easily, so it's easy to do. It's just the way I do things. So here we go. So a little bit of parsley, and I only did that for a presentation for garnish, for when they open up the beautiful leaf. Okay, parsley doesn't taste like anything, but it's a beautiful presentation and a beautiful garnish for when you have so much flavor into the meat and into the masa. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna go ahead and do this, and I'm gonna put a big spoon of that. And you have to go by the weight of the masa that you're doing. So let's keep that in mind. I know people comment, and I used to go back on my comments a lot when I first started my YouTube channel. If you personally need help on anything, just hit me up on my email. It's that simple. cheflove1950kissthecook@gmail.com. All right, so, and then we're going to add some more. So I do sofrito for color and also a little flavor to the masa as well. I'm going to put some more of this because remember, we're using this on all the masa. So I got to go ham with the parsley. There we go. All right. And that's pretty much it. This meat has so much flavor. It has olive oil, everything, as you've seen earlier before. And I still have yet to break this down and cut it. Look at this, guys. Look at this. Your girl does not play. Trust me. Your cooking queen. Where's the bone? Where's the bone? Look at that. So, you know, I do this all in front of you guys again. So, your girl getting busy up in the kitchen. And like I said, I also, you know, I get down for my subscribers, too. I hook them up as well, and I'm grateful for the love and support. So, okay, and I still have to, basically, I just take a spoon. I'll show you how I do it, and I put it here so that way. So, I'm going to start out with the pork first, and then, of course, the chicken is just chilling and just laid back in that deliciousness. Say hello. I'm crazy like that. You have to talk to your food if you're a chef, as we know. So I'm going to start out with the pork, and then we'll move to the chicken. You're going to see all these beautiful clips. So I'm going to keep pushing and moving. And from here on, it's just going to be pictures and slideshows. No more videos. Your girl. Okay, guys. So I did want you to see me pull this out before I actually start the pasteles. So, and this is how my dad's side taught me. My dad loves this. It's so much more flavorful. And also, like I said, there's a lot of mix in this besides the pork fat, the regular meat, olives. You know, I got it all. So I just wanted to mention also that Okay, guys, so as I was saying, if you're interested in any of my pasteles, I am starting to deliver as of this weekend. Don't hit me up. Don't hit me up in the comments. Just hit me up on my email, which is chef.love1950@gmail.com. Okay, so I'm always on top of that, my emails, with my subscribers. I do some texts for those who have the number. But, so yeah, I'm definitely getting it in, and you don't want to miss this flavor. $2 a pop, and $20 for 10 minutes. I do them so good. So I put my work into this, and the flavors are on point. The meat, everything. And that's why I like to do one-on-ones on my YouTube channel, because this way you see exactly how I do everything step by step. Your girl. So hit me up. Okay, guys, so I'm just doing a quick little video of the masa I put on the side, and I'm getting ready to get down, as you see. Okay, so I still have this left, right? Okay, so I have half, same ingredients, kept it simple. The meat has a lot of flavor. I just would like to show you guys step by step everything that I'm doing. Is truthful. Because I am that girl. And this is gonna go in here.
Isn't she beautiful? Isn't she wonderful? Cheers. Morning, still doing those best things. Coming for my subscribers tomorrow.